Hello everybody, my name is Julien Pastor and today I am with Lauriane from Interscience and she wants to talk about innovation, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Let's go and let's find out what it is.
You don't want to go for a ride, do you? We could get out of the palace, see the world.
Is it safe?
Sure, do you trust me?
So hello Lauriane, we are going to talk about the famous Kane Station.
Sure.
That's what I saw on your booth. I want to know more about this product. Where does it come from? How did you have the idea and so on?
So I didn't personally have the idea.
Really?
Yes, but my smart colleagues in France did. So I think the idea was, you know, we've been in microbiology for a while now, 40 years. And we have a pretty complete range of products, mm-hmm. and that includes colony counters. So we have four models actually, and we've really improved the quality. But in terms of the process itself, we're limited by the fact that it's an endpoint reading, right?
Okay.
So there was a moment where if we wanted to improve the accuracy of the reading, we needed to change the process and actually switch to real-time reading. So
okay.
What we did was actually, it was a really smart idea, just stick a colony counter inside the incubator and have it count as the colonies are growing.
We know that a lot of companies try to develop this kind of product, but you finally managed to do something that works.
We have smarter engineers.
You are able to scan the plates every 30 minutes, that's right?
So that's correct, yeah. We actually, the recurrence can be either 30 minutes or an hour. On our two first models, on the scan station that holds one or 200 plates,
okay.
and on the one that holds 300 plates, that's only once every hour because it takes
okay.
longer to run through all the plates.
Okay, so what kind of customer do you target with this solution?
So really, anyone who needs to incubate plates and who, like, you know, need to enumerate or do presence or absence, so detection of bacterial load. So the answer is anyone in microbiology, but really there are some features that might target it better to some markets or more specific to some markets. Environmental monitoring and pharmacology and
yes.
cosmetics, you know, you can program the temperature. It's a Peltier effect incubator, so you can program
okay.
changes ahead of time.
Nice.
And the reading, you know, being able to detect by color means you can use chromogenic agar. Reading in real time also means that you have a slightly improving accuracy in terms of false negatives and false positives, so that's good for enumeration in food,
mm-hmm.
you know, things like that.
Yes. So how to define this kind of technology? Is it an alternative method? How do you
so
define it?
It's not really an alternative method, though it could be qualified as a rapid microbiology method,
mm-hmm.
But we're still following the traditional method, right? We're still plating the sample on agar, but because you have that growth curve and because you're able to follow the growth curve as it's happening, say for example coliforms that typically the S&P will call for them being in the incubator for 24 hours,
mm-hmm.
but what we've observed is that they grow between hour 8 and hour 10 of incubation.
Mm-hmm.
So if you at hour 12 see that you've plateaued for 2 hours, you're already free to do whatever you want
you
with those
results.
And then you can leave them in the incubator for up to 24 hours, but you have those results really at hour 10. So
okay.
you're saving, you know, 60% incubation time.
I saw your software. You can have time lapse, things like that.
Yeah.
Really easy to use, touch screen.
Yeah.
So can you explain to us what is with the features about the software?
Right. So the software is actually really, like, it's really slick. It looks really nice. I don't know what you thought about it, but
yeah,
I really enjoy presenting it because you go through, so there's different features, you know, you have the running analysis at a glance, you have all your plates, you can see how far along you are in the incubation, you can set threshold per plate, so you know, you come in and you see this plate is already out of threshold, this plate is still going, etc. You have the result page where you know, an approved user gets to approve the results and then they get exported. And per plate, as the colonies are growing, you actually get a time lapse. So with that, those pictures taken every half hour, that creates a time lapse
mm-hmm.
video that you can consult at any time and then you can export and you can work with this.
About the consumable, I mean, can I use my regular plate or do you have like captive consumable?
So no, that was also a choice to keep the system open. So use your own agar, and that's also something we did with the food industry in mind.
What's the next product? I mean, this one is really nice, but what's the future? I mean, you will be able to throw away the plate yourself, to load the plate yourself. I don't know. What's the...
So I know you already asked my boss this question, and I can't tell you everything that we have in the pipeline. But I mean, you can think about like what type of innovation that mm-hmm. would bring about.
So thank you very much, Lauriane, for your explanation. I hope this video has been useful for you. If you have any question for Lauriane or myself, please leave your comment below this video. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.